Hi friends, welcome to Toppers Institute Daily Current Affairs. This is Bikshapati. So today let us discuss about some of the important current affairs which came newspapers on July 2, 2020. The first point is here, Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced the extended the program Prime Minister Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana. So this program will be extended up to, extended in the sense of the implementing. So implementing up to November 2020. So up to November 2020, this program will be implemented. That means extended in the manner of the implementation is extended. That means continuing process. Actually, that Prime Minister Garib Kalyan Yojana, that program started in December 2016. So due to the COVID-19 pandemic, provide the food grains to the people of India, particularly the 80 crore people are beneficiaries under this program. And government of India will be spent allocated for this program about 90,000 crores for 80 crore people, that these are the beneficiaries under this program, Prime Minister Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana. That is the 80 crore people are beneficiaries, are benefited from this program. How many crores that is allocated up to November 2020 for the implementation of this program, that is about, 90 crores that money fund allocated for this program, Prime Minister Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana. So under this program, Government of India provide or supplies the food grains, particularly rice per one person, 5 kg rice, and for some people, particularly North India, wheat, 5 kg and 1 kg of the pulses. This is supply free of cost, freely supplied by the Government of India. This is the purpose of the Prime Minister Garib Kalyan Yojana. Why that Government of India has taken this decision? No? Because still that COVID-19 pandemic affected the so many communities, so many people in India. So that is the reason. So according to the 2013 Act is there, friends. So in 2013, that Government Act is there, that is the National Food Security Act. So provide the food material to the poor people, that is the one of the National Food Security Act. So Security Act, according to that, Government of India has been implementing the Prime Minister Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana since March 2020 onwards. So this program has been implementing by the Government of India. So next, friends, E Kisan Dhan app. So this is the app developed by one bank, that is the HDFC Housing Development Finance Corporation. HDFC launched one app for the farmers benefited, that is the E Kisan Dhan app. So E Kisan Dhan app, so what type of the question expecting from this KDI? E Kisan Dhan app, it is launched by the, prepared by the which bank in India? That is the HDFC, and the present chairman of the HDFC is Deepak Parekh. And then Kisan means here farmer, then farmers are beneficiary, and this is useful to the farmers only, knowing the government schemes, so how to get the loan from the banks, and like that information available in the E Kisan Dhan app, that is by the HDFC. So Kisan credit cards is, that is the government purpose. This is the a private bank HDFC started E Kisan Dhan app. And next news, that is the Government of India, particularly the Union Home Ministry imposed one act, that is the name of the act is APSA 1958. So six more months in Nagaland. So what is APSA? Why that Government of India Union Home Ministry imposed this APSA in Nagaland? Because of Nagaland is announced as the disturbed area for 6 months. That is Nagaland, because of this some terrorist activities, taken place in the Nagaland. That is the reason in Nagaland the government of India Union Home Ministry imposed the AFSA Act. So what is AFSA, friends? AFSA, what AFSA, you know, it is the act that is by government of India did in 1958. What is that is AFSA? Armed Forces Special Powers Act. Armed Forces, so that means Armed Forces means here Rashtriya Rifle, Assam Rifles, Rashtriya Rifles, CRPF, BSF, like that Armed Forces, government of India has given the right to arrest that terrorist, arrest that disturbed person, even can fire also, even can fire on those persons. So can that means here the terrorist. So by the Armed Forces Special Powers Act, that is came in which year, friends? 1958. In 1958, Armed Special Powers Act, Special Powers Act came in enforced in India. And already we knew, so that earlier classes we discussed, that is the one person is there. She belongs to Manipur state. Her name is Iromu Chanu Sharmila. So Iromu Chanu Sharmila, who fought against the to ban the Armed Force Special Powers Act in that state. So that is Iromu Chanu Sharmila, we called as the Iron Woman of the Manipur. So in last that previous exams we got the type of the bit. So which person we called as the Iron Woman of the Manipur, that is the Iromu Chanu Sharmila. So who fought against which act, you know? So she fought against the AFSA. Because of the implementation of the AFSA, some civilians also faced some problems. So that but this AFSA, you know, that is a suppress the terrorist activities. Okay, now that is the main purpose. Abbreviation of the AFSA is Armed Force Special Powers Act from 1958. And then Ministry of the Human Resources Development. So Ministry of Human Resources Development launched one degree, very first time, that is a world's first online BSc degree. World's first online BSc degree. So many online BSc degrees are there, but here the degree in programming and data science. So Bachelor of the Science degree started with that optional programming and data science. So the first country in the world started the BSc degree in programming and data science by the India. And this course is prepared by the IIT Madras. Friends, the present Union Minister of Human Resource Development Minister is Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank. And next point is here IOC, Indian Oil Corporation. So new chairman is appointed on July 1st, 2020. The new chairman of the Indian Oil Corporation is, that is Srikanth Madhav Vaidya. So yesterday we discussed, that is July 1st. July 1st we celebrate as a, that is a GST day in India. And then Foundation Day of the State Bank of India. So along with these 2 days, one more day also there, that is a National Doctors Day. We also celebrate on July 1. So National Doctors Day we celebrate on July 1st. That is the birth anniversary of the Dr. Bidhan Chandra Roy. So Bidhan Chandra Roy, who worked as a CM to the West Bengal state. So his birth anniversary celebrate as a National Doctors Day. And Government of India gave one theme to the National Doctors Day, July 1st, 2020. That is a lesson, lesson means decline. Lessen the mortality of the COVID-19. Mortality means death. So we have to try to decline that COVID-19 means coronavirus disease 2019. So this is the theme of the National Doctors Day, July 1, 2020 is lessen the mortality of COVID-19. And United Nations General Assembly started one group. The group name is here Alliance for Poverty Eradication, to fight against the eradication, to decline the poverty in respective countries that alliance for the poverty eradication. That means the countries which facing the poverty is the one of the problem that country is dead. So India is the founding member in alliance for poverty eradication. What type of the question we are expecting? Recently India joined which of the alliance that is started by the United Nations General Assembly, that is the Alliance for Poverty Eradication, and India is the founding member in Alliance for the Poverty Eradication. Who is the present president of the, or 74th president of the United Nations General Assembly? His name is Nijani Muhammad Bande, and from September 1st 2020 onwards a new president is appointed. His name is, that is a Turkish person. Turkey, the person belongs to Turkey, Turkish person. His name is the Volker Bozkurt. And then Uganda. So Uganda is the first country submitted a red plus report. Red, R-E-D-D plus report. What is red plus report? You know, the abbreviation tells us the red plus report. That is submitted to which organization? That is the UNFCC. What is UNFCC? United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Once again, my dear friends, United Nations Framework on United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. So, Uganda is the first country in the world. So, that is African country. Uganda is the first country in the world to submitted Red Plus report to the UNFCC. Purpose of the Red Plus, you know, that means the UNFCC will give some fund to the this country. What is Red Plus? You are reducing emissions from the deforestation. Because of the deforestation, you know, so many carbon emissions are reduced. So, reducing the emissions of the from the deforestation and forest degradation. So, if the forest degradation is there, if the deforestation is there, but more encourages the afforestation. Due to the encourages the afforestation, that automatically carbon emissions are utilized by the that plants. So, finally, so that is the degraded. So, reducing emissions from the deforestation and the forest degradation, that is called the abbreviation of the RED. So, here, this is the first country in the world submitted that report RED plus to the UNFCCC, that is by the Uganda. The capital city of the Uganda is Kampala. And then, on sport point is there, Wisden, one of the famous magazine about the sports, that is the about the sport, that is the Wisden, published in England. So Wisden gave an award honor to the our Indian cricketer, that is a very famous batsman and bowler and fielder, that is, his name is Ravindra Jadeja. What is that honor, you know, what is that award, you know? Most valuable player in 21st century by the Wisden. Most valuable player in 21st century, that award by the Wisden given to the that is the Ravindra Jadeja of India. And second most valuable player in 21st century, that is the Muthiah Muralidhar. That Muthiah Muralidhar is a bowler who belongs to that Sri Lanka country. These are the some of the important points which came newspapers on July 2, 2020. So thank you, friends. We will meet again tomorrow.